I'm Andy Cherkasky at Golden Law. Today, I want to talk to you about what COVID has been like in military justice over the last year and where it's going, what it's going to look like in the future. So let me just start by saying welcome to our office. This is my office. Katie and I do all of our work here. Josh Traeger, our partner, is based out of Colorado. You've seen videos of his before. That's his home office. We wanted to kind of show you where we work because during COVID, there has been so much more of our work that's been done remotely. Skype or Zoom or Microsoft Teams. We have been able to represent clients all over the world without having to travel anywhere, and it's been very acceptable to the courts and to the various military hearings that we've been a part of because it's obviously the change that we've all been going through. But I think that on that topic, it's really important to discuss what you should be expecting of your attorney during COVID and what that means for your ability to have one-on-one connections and the ability to really grow close, share what you want to share, understand how the case is being prepared, and then finally feel really assured that the people that we're talking to, even if it's through video teleconferencing, is done in such a convincing and compelling way that it leads to your success. It leads to the win in your case. So what does that mean? What do we do to get that done? Well, first you have to know that we are the only military-focused law firm that has a national reputation. And what I mean by that is in the national media, in the national voice in Washington, D.C., we believe that our firm stands out above the rest. That's because we are routinely, and by that I mean multiple times a week, we find ourselves on national news networks commenting on the latest stories, the latest legal issues, as well as the latest things that are going on in the military. And because of that, we've had the opportunity to set up really a formal studio setting. So whenever we are doing anything on camera, whether that's for the national news or whether that's for our clients in a small hearing in the middle of nowhere, when we come into those hearings remotely, we do so with great technology, great lighting, just those extra little pieces that helps the court understand that we're prepared. We look ready to go, and they're starting to get that same sort of sense of personality, the same sort of sense of personalization that you get when attorneys present their case right in front of the judge, face to face. You know, we have not seen a great deal of downside for our clients with the remote participation. You know, we don't like that. We like to be sitting right next to our clients. We like to be anywhere that they are so that they can feel our passion for the case. But we have continued to see a tremendous number of successes, even over video. Just this morning, I woke up to a judge's ruling on a motions hearing that we had yesterday. We were successful in convincing the judge through video teleconference to produce certain witnesses and to give them immunity at an upcoming trial. I think that's in part because we looked ready to go. We looked professional. The camera work and the digital aspects behind it really worked out well. You know, that's just one example. We've got all sorts of other examples. We've got discharge boards that we've been winning. And I think that we are going to be seeing a lot more of this in the future. There are certainly the ends of the cases, the big verdicts, the things that affect our clients' freedoms, liberties, and really the question of whether they could be going to jail that require in-person representation every time. The jury's got to be there, the judge has to be there, and the witnesses have to be there. But short of it being a criminal trial, the law is not as requiring of that in-person right for a defendant. Now, we will always show up whenever we can when our clients request it and the courts allow it. But in those cases where we can't, I think you should know, and we hope that this video helps you understand, that we are leaps and bounds above our competition in being ready to represent you in court, in hearings, and before commanders through Zoom, through Skype, through FaceTime or any other sort of video teleconferencing systems so that we can make sure that we get that personal connection even during this time of chaos and into the future when we think that there's going to be a lot less of the travel and in-person hearings that our clients will have the rights to. So we're ready to help you through that. I think we're going to do a great job. I hope this video helps establish that. And if you've got any questions, instead of just a regular call with us, we're always happy to schedule and set up a video teleconference call through Zoom Zoom or whatever with our clients to make sure that you're getting really that personal attention that you're looking for. Until next time, thank you for tuning in. I'm Andy Trukowski.